One, two, three. They just told me one, two, three to start. Hey guys, still waiting for my breakfast, which now is going to be lunch. But the good thing about it is I got a cup of coffee, okay? Listen to me.
My elite, friend, your breakfast is fasting, so.
The elite dog. We're going to talk about the elite dog, okay? I called the elite dog and this mutt came here to play with me.
This mutt?
I love him. I love him so much. He's just a puppy. He's
ice cream.
8 months old. And you know what happens? He came as a vacation to my home. Okay. He needed to know his roots down in Brazil. And he's nothing but um cachorro carioca. Cachorro carioca. Tá bom. Vá pra lá. Deixa a gente trabalhar aqui, ok? Tá. Você fica tranquilo, filho da mãe. Tá. Let's go. Elite dog, okay. So what happens is we're talking about with somebody, and three topics kind of mix into each other, and as the conversation got developed, we end up with the lead dog. So we're doing a reversal of how everything really happens, because the topic of elite dog was the ending of the conversation, but I'm going to tell you a little background of that conversation. And then we'll talk a little bit about the lead dog. So prepare yourself, go get the popcorn, pause the video, go get the coffee, the whatever. So we're gonna talk about the lead dog, but we're gonna talk about why the lead dog. So I have two guys, I told you several things that got mixed up. One guy asked me, what happens if you mix one dog, why your dogs can get along and the pit bull is not supposed to, and explain to him that, you know, society called, I will say 100%, because the number is so small that it becomes 100%. When you have, you know, 11 million and only one is good, then, you know, it's still 11 million. You know, the bank will take it, say, well, you shorten dollars, okay, we'll put it under sleep. Like it's the money will come in and say, it's on me, go ahead. Put the $11 million in the voucher. You just drop 11. He was short $1 from 11 million, but just take it as 11 million. You know, life is like that. And 99% of all the dogs that people call pit bulls around the world, and I don't say these in a term to bash them, because I started there. See, it'll be totally unfair for me to bash them just to bash them. I don't want the creation of non-elite dogs anymore, but it is impossible. I don't control the world. But I'll tell you this. 99%, 100% of the dogs are not elite dogs. They call pit bull anything, and they breed these things like crazy. Everybody wants to be like, you know, or many times they want to do what the person they got the dog from is. So they get a puppy, a little female, and they looking to see when is she going to be out. They see the neighbor that has a dog, and that dog there, oh, you know, you got the male, I got the female, let's make some puppies, and you go destroying the breed. The elite dog is that easy to destroy. The elite dog is like that measle that can go and kill a lot of things and destroy a lot of things. But he's so flexible that a little match can crack on this atomic bomb and make it explode. Does that make any sense to you? One little match, light it up and destroy it. But if you take this bomb and you drop it in on Hitler, You save the world, you save the future of America and the future of Europe and so on and so forth. So kind of you get the idea. So is the elite dog is easy to destroy and it's very difficult to build. That's one of the basic things on it. Basic things. And people say, I got this dog, I'm going to breed it. You got a male, you got a female. What about 50%, 20%? This is basura, it's trash. I want to get the Thai dog. Yeah. I'm trying to get a Thai dog down over there in whatever state. I want to get a Thai dog, man. I got this dog. Who should I breed it to? Who should I breed this dog to? It's totally, totally ridiculous, the level of stupidity. Breeding is for a person that the man is elite. The lead dog has a man that is also elite. Cannot be an elite dog without having an elite man. Because the lead man creates his own family of dogs. The elite dog cannot, what's the difference between a good dog, an excellent dog, and an elite dog? Excellent dog is gonna be major in one or two areas of his life. And he might have something in his pedigree that might be good, some cross, some this, some that, And while you're doing this process of crossing, breeding, blah, 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 you're infusing into it a lot of different men. And these men have different standards. Not all can be elite. That is a trick. Let me explain to you something. You have a dog, you said this dog is excellent. He might be excellent producer or whatever, depending so many variables on what you call elite and why. And which time was he an elite dog back in the 90s, 2000, or he's an elite dog in 2021, where the swamp in America is the only thing left. What is elite and what time? When he became elite? You know, it's very important. So he was elite in the right times. Okay. So there you go. The dog is elite. His pedigree to continue with greatness. Top and bottom, different men, different men, different men, different men, different men. Automatically, all these men, they don't have the same standards. Automatically, at one point, there's weaklings all over the place, this dog. Weaklings. So when we talk about the lead dog, the lead dog is so special. He has a great mother, a great father. His four grandparents are superb, amazing dogs from great men or the great man. And behind that is the same thing. And behind that, dogs that are relevant, dogs that are extremely important to the breed, dogs that are, when a dog is so important to the breed, it becomes what is called a key dog. It's a key dog. Without this key, you don't open up the future of the breed. Grand Champion Mayday, he was the key dog to the future. Today you find Mayday dogs all over the place. You go to the little backyard breed, man, we got some Mayday dogs. Hola amigo, tenemos unos perros Mayday over here, very nice Mayday. And you go, my friend, how you doing? I do have some very elite Mayday dogs. That doesn't work like that, man. You know, pedigree, whatever. People come and talk to me about Barracuda. Okay, so what? I saw Barracuda. Nice dog, a little slow, but nice dog, yeah. I picked up at one time 26 or 28 dogs in a white band from Texas to Florida. We brought all the 28 dogs, beautiful dogs. I was in happy land. You know, Barracuda with Isabel, Barracuda with Annabelle, Barracuda with Bonita, Barracuda with this, with a monkey, blah, 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 all this. Where are all those dogs in my breeding program? They did not qualify to my eye to be quality in my breeding program. Chico, I have 14 dogs over here. They're all 2 years old. You know, you could take them and see if these dogs can be of quality to be dogs in a show display. Exposition. I said I can take the 12, 14 dog, I can't remember. And by the way, I have a dog called Muñeco. One of the dogs there was called Muñeco too. And another one's called Oso and some other names I remember. My friend, they were beautiful dogs, I tell you that. Beautiful, amazing looking dogs. They look like Mayday. Couldn't keep one of them. One, could not keep one. And so when somebody comes in and flashes and buys, oh yeah, man. Good luck to you.
Maybe for someone that doesn't have any dog.
Maybe to his standard. Maybe the guy's coming from a German Shepherd or from some other dog. And that's fine. But I'm just talking about from my point of elite. Okay, so let's put that very clear. I do respect if someone wants to have him as pet. We're talking about me, personally, me. Okay, it's just a personal thing to me. So same thing with Hunch. You know, I saw Hunch puppies before. People even knew who Hunch was. 17-month-old Hunch was already being bred. So let me tell you a little bit about an example that it was extremely nice, I will say, in a way, and sad in another way. I got a contact by a man and sent me a picture of his dog and tell me, can you please tell me if this dog is real American Pitbull Terrier? Can you help me? And he's a nice guy. And I look at the picture of the dog and I say, Jesus Christ, wow. I can see Mayday here. I can see a lot of macho buck. This guy got a lot of macho buck. He was a red, red nose. A lot of macho buck. And the dog, I look at the legs, I look at everything, the dog is a mutt. Dog is a mutt. The guy don't even know how the dog is bred. And he's sad. When my friend VA moved to Ecuador didn't have elite dogs. at the time. Really high quality animals, American Pitbull Terriers. So this man that is at that moment the most highly respected and wanted breeder in the world, moves back to his country and takes with him the cream of the crop of the American Pitbull Terrier at that time. From America, American dogs. When he bred them, he sent all the best dogs all back to America. And I asked him, I said, you don't sell to the locals? He said, I sell to some locals, but I know what I sell them. He said, okay, what do you mean? He said, Chico, I cannot sell them the very best, because if I do, soon they'll have a shop next to me and they'll try to compete with me and close me down. I said, that nasty? I was very young. I said, people are very nasty. People that want to have what you have, take away what you got, so they can have them and they can say they're better than you. That's what they want to do. So it's just the dog world. And for some of you people that are coming here, that you're not coming from the dog world, you might be starting to understand why being in the dog world is nasty, why being in the dog world is not good, why only owning one single dog in your home and enjoying all the benefits without the drama. So that elite dog, those elite dogs at the time, they became today nothing. And to America, some of those Mayday dogs got bred by people that didn't know nothing about it. You know, I remember this guy in boxing, the Mayweather, and Mayweather, rest in peace, the uncle, he used to say a thing. He says, you don't know shit about boxing. And it became something that everybody says now. You don't know shit about boxing. You'll tell millions of people you don't know shit about the American Pitbull Terrier. Absolutely. 40, 50 years in the dogs, you do not know shit about the American Pitbull Terrier. You don't know nothing about dogs. You are a guy that pick up shit from a dog, and that's different. You clean dogs and stuff like that. That is different. You have passion for it, I understand. You have desire, I understand. But being elite, you are not. So
it's the same thing as a person that loves basketball and never going to be like...
Play basketball Jordan. Every day, and he's only 5'6", collect all the cars, has all the t-shirts, knows every play, knows the name of every... referee and every arena and every game and how many points were in which quarter and so on and so forth. The guy is just like a library of basketball. He's never going to be Jordan. He's just going to be a guy that talks about it. On the other hand, you're going to have guys that love LeBron and they hate Jordan, and they never even touch a ball. Never touch a ball. Exactly. And some of them touch a ball and they became nobody. So that's the world we live in. So smart people got to look for the right thing all the time. So the lead dog, the elite dog is a dog that is very special. It's surrounded by all these beautiful things. It's easily to be destroyed, like I just gave you the sample of Ecuador. The dogs went to Ecuador, leftovers came out the bag, the guy destroyed them. 25 years later, somebody called me with an extremely mud-looking macho buck Mayday dog. You know, and it's not the fault of macho buck or the fault of Mayday. And maybe not the fault of VA, but the thing about it is that you sell them a dog. You say, no, Mr. Lopez, I'm not breeding. They take the dog, they go breed it to some mud in the neighborhood. They think it's the greatest idea in the world. They're going to somehow, let's try some dog. I wonder what happened when you cross this dog with this bloodline with the bloodline. I wonder what happened. This wonder what happened. Once you make this happen, you have puppies. They turn out to be good in your standard, which is very low standard, bad for very high standard, and then you start to contaminate the world. The world does not need breeders. The world of the American Pitbull Terrier don't need you to be a breeder. The American Pitbull Terrier world does not need you to be a breeder. Doesn't need you. What you need to do, because you breed dogs, you buy dogs, and at the very end of the day, you have a whole bunch of dogs. You don't have a great one. And if you buy a great one from the very beginning, the first time you bred him, you destroy. And now you destroy everything. So the beautiful thing is about you keeping that beautiful dog that came from that really amazing pedigree dog man. The pedigree of that man. Let me get a piece of paper. Let me start writing down here, please. I want to hear everything that you got to say. I want to listen to you. I want to listen to your YouTube channel. Let me get a pit, and we're going to do the Chico Lopez test. That's going to be called the Chico Lopez test. Before I listen to you, we're going to do the Chico Lopez test. Okay, let me write down here your first five grand champions. What are the names? Your next 10 grand champions, your Rum Dogs. What do we have here in this area of Rum Dogs and grand champions that you made? Oh, you don't have, I know this guy, I read this book, boo-boo. Well, that guy right there, he might sound sweet on the phone, but he ain't nobody, absolutely nobody. So you do the Chico Lopez test, officially, that's the name of it. You do the Chico Lopez test to all these guys, and sooner or later, you're going to know that you're talking to nobodies. Two guys that don't know shit about dogs. So the lead dog has to be blessed with the greatest dogman behind it, with the greatest pedigree, the greatest journey, all the great dogs around him, all the great dogs around him. And more importantly, if he has a lot of great dogs, also you got to look around for the crappy dogs. How many crappy dogs? We don't find crappy dogs. Maybe all the dogs are great, or maybe they didn't sell dogs to everybody. But if you see a guy that everybody talks about, that guy, you go say, let me do the Chico Lopez test on this guy that everybody talks about. Okay, give me the, just give me five. Don't give me 10, give me five. If you give me five, then we go to another five. But let's start with small number, number five. Five first grand champions. And you'll see these legends all of a sudden, ooh, right here. And then you go to the stage number two. That's stage number two. This grand champion, what is the quality really? Is this from like neighborhood, you know, homeboys, and yeah, man, yeah, 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 real recognized, real man. And, órale, compadre, ¿cómo está usted? No, hombre. You need to know exactly where things come, how to do things. Today, 2020, what is the greatest thing that ever happened? 2021, I'm sorry, but 2021 feels like 2022.2, you know, but 2.0. So anyhow, let me just tell you this. What happens when for a second, I just started thinking about all the bad things that happened in 2021 in 7-8 days, I'm sorry. So what happens is that great man, that great person is gonna have great dogs, but he has to have those numbers. If he doesn't pass the test, you ask some guy, he's like, oh man, yeah, this guy, let's start writing down all his grand champions and champions. He don't pass stage one. When we get the names, stage two, we look at the quality, right? Right, we look at the quality. And we go to stages, and once you get to the stages, and you know, you call me and I will check all the rest of the stuff, you know? Is that guy a gambler? A gambler can have 20, 35 grand champions. They are all snipers, you know? Because he's a gambler, he's looking to make money. So, did your cousin have a cat? Let's put it with my dog. He has, you know, five cats. He's a grand champion against cats, against Dorman pitchers and stuff like that. And I'm talking about this is what they do in the swamp, right? And I'm making fun of it because I'm making fun of the thugs and the lowlifes in the swamp that they still current doing dogs in America, and they shouldn't, and I don't sell them dogs. So the point is this, we need to make sure that we do understand that there are levels from this. So in the United States, but the world today is a very different world than it used to be. And what we have is this, we have the opportunity to really, really get confused and buy the worst dogs in history, the worst. In the 60s, they didn't have bullies and micros and macros and all this stuff. So this is the worst time to buy an American Pit Bull Terrier. Yet at the same time, through a very small window, is the best time to buy an American Pit Bull Terrier. Just check and do the Chico Lopez test. We'll see what happens. Run the Chico Lopez test through all these people and you'll find out what they have. Greatest dogs in the world are not for everybody. The elite dogs are not for everybody. And if you cannot afford one, if you don't qualify for one, and you have a dog that you can love and care for, that's good. That's actually, on a human level, is very, very good for you to love that dog and embrace a dog. But when you are that man that you can actually be sort of, you know, I was looking at a picture of one of my clients, a good guy, he's a very good guy, and he has a bully dog that he has as a pet. You know, it's a bully, kind of like gray color with white spots or white markings. And he has this dog that he loves very much. He knows his dog is not an elite dog. He maybe thought was an elite when he bought it. But he's sitting down on the bed, petting the dog, and he's smiling, holding or looking at his dog that he got from me called Ernie. And I look at the picture and I said, this is a man that makes his dreams come true. He wanted to have an American Pitbull Terrier. He got this, which is what everybody, the common dog that everybody knows, and now he has an elite dog. And when I ask him, well, there's a video about it, and I ask him, how do you find me? You find the haters, you find these. He says, yes, I found those too, but I want to have the best and blah, 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 and make the best, and he has the best. So that right there was a complete picture. When I look at the picture, that was because I understood why he told me that he went all over the place. He saw dogs here and there, and a lot of lies, a lot of haters, a lot of people talk lies and stuff like this about me. But then he saw my great clients, saw my page, he saw who I am, and said, now I know what they hated. And all of a sudden, he wanted to have the lead dog. So he had in his bed a dog that was not elite and a dog that was extremely, extremely elite. And so that is the end of the story, because what we want to have as humans, we want to have that elite dog. We want to have that elite dog. Chico Lopez, when he was young, wanted to have that elite dog. He couldn't have an elite dog with a certainty because everybody didn't have a man that says, I am the elite dog man. And he had to become the dog man to create those elite dogs, you know? And so I got the elite dog, and now I put the elite dog in elite families. You don't have to be rich, you just have to be great. You have to be honest, have a word, don't be mixed with trash, don't be mixed with bad people, you know? It's very sad, people that they could have been great owners of my dogs, they decide, I'm gonna go check all over the place, and then they become friends with people. And I never got into the dogs because I wanted to be friends with anybody. It never crossed, like, oh my God, I woke up one day and like I'm with a suit and tie working in Manhattan, and I'm saying, if God only allows me to be friends with all the dog men in the internet or in the streets, that didn't happen. I woke up and I said, I want to have the greatest dog on earth. That's what I want. And that's what I got, greatest dog on earth. I'm very happy, very extremely happy. So guys, now you know what the lead dog is. Now you know that if the dog goes to a whole country as an elite dog establishment with 50, 60 elite dogs, or good dogs, excellent dogs, and some elite dogs, and whatever, he goes there, the best man of the times, so he goes there, and whatever he leaves behind, humans will take that and have ideas of breeding pedigrees with pedigrees, they'll breed them together, and next time, some down the line, somebody's gonna call a guy like Chico Lopez and say, can you please tell me if my mutt is a real pit bull? This is very important. This message that I'm just giving you right now is very, very to the heart of the breed, to the heart of the breed. You understand what I just said? And also you just understood that in a dog that looks nice, you know, you look at the pedigree and you see a whole bunch of men. Each man don't have the same standard. So automatically you have a problem. The standard of the man, the most important thing is the man behind the dog. You already learned what is the Chico Lopez test. Nico Chico Lopez test, we're gonna check you, my friend. Give me this, give me that, give me that. You don't have it.
Fail.
You fail, my friend. So how can I listen to you? How can I watch your channel? How can I watch your channel, whatever channel you have or website you have or whatever you have? How can I watch you if you are nobody? How can I talk to you about science if you are the guy that picks up the trash and flush the toilets in the men's room? Why? Why? Why should I do that? You need, before I talk to you, you need to know who you are. A lesson you should all learn. Apply this to boxing, apply this to whatever you like, basketball. When you go to university, when you go to school, you go talk to the right professor, talk to the right person. Don't talk to the janitor, you understand? Talk to the guy that knows. Don't talk to the guy that lay the bricks. Talk to the architect.
Sometimes a person wants to learn how to clean the toilet. Maybe they want to talk to these people.
Maybe so. So you got to talk to the source, the right person. And many times when you go into a place and everybody points in a direction, you got to go and apply the Chico Lopez test. Listen, just to confirm, Mr. whatever your name is. You make yourself, not the, you know, I gave this dog to Juanito and I give this dog to John. And they came back and they make this and you don't know. No. What do you make? Yourself, you, my friend. Why should I trust you? So if you go to a doctor and you don't see in the walls his diploma, you don't see nothing, he's not dressed like a doctor with the thing here and everything, and you see him dressing like me, like this, talking about to you like, listen, my man, let me open up your heart and let me put some pills in you and let me inject you with this injection. And they don't look like a doctor. The place doesn't look like he's a doctor. He doesn't have a diploma. Why should I listen to this fool? Same thing in the dogs, man. Same thing in the dogs. This video right here, my wife probably gonna tell me you talk too much. But this video right here, if you're smart, you learn. Now, you cannot force, I promise you, the donkey, you cannot force him to drink the water. You cannot. You understand? He look at the video and they'll put some comment. Yeah, man, you talk too much shit. Yeah, yeah, homeboy. Yeah, man. No sabe nada de perros este güey, este vato. You're going to see all kinds of people. Hey, man, I do it in all different things. And people, hey, man, this guy is racist. Este es un racista, güey. No. Listen to me. I want you guys to stay cool. Okay? I want you to grow up. I want you to man up. I want you to learn. Stop following fools. You understand? This channel right here, I'm not selling you anything. I'm not selling you a dog. And all your homeboys and other people, I'm not selling them a dog. I'm teaching you the facts so you can know the truth. Now, I'm going to give you a warning. Sometimes you don't want to know the truth. Sometimes you do not want to know that your dog is a mutt. Sometimes if you know the truth and somebody tells you that your dog is a mutt, you get upset. And then you hate that guy. Oh, I hate Chico Lopez.
He
told me he has a dog that he minds is not good. Start crying. You understand?
Like a little bitch.
Like a little bitch. That's correct. And so what happens to this thing? Listen, I don't want to sell your dog. Really? You know, they send me some, how do you call it, snapshots. I get him. Boom, boom. He said, what is this? He said, bro, they're really upset. You know, why you do this? He said, but I don't want to, I will never sell a dog. They won't qualify. They already called me. I told them no. So don't even worry what Chico Lopez do, where he goes, whatever. You know why you shouldn't worry about it? You should worry about your life. And the second, my dogs, who I breed, who I don't breed, they're not available for you. They're not available. Why should you worry about who's making dinner and what they're cooking if you are not going to be fed? They tell you, listen, hit the street, get a shovel, get a few rocks, get some dirt, and eat that dirt. They're not going to let you eat. So don't worry about Chico Lopez so much. But if you don't want to worry about Chico Lopez that much, if you wake up in the morning, you're like, ooh, you cannot sleep thinking about me because the envy and stuff like that, let me give you a little tip. I'm here to stay for many, many years. I'll be the legend that people write books about. I'll be the legend that I write books and people when they write about me. I'll be the legend that my wife will write books about me when I'm dead. And people will always love me. I'll be relevant. And if you hate me, I promise you one thing, you will be relevant. And there will be nothing more stupid than me called Chico Lopez hater. You guys take care. Life is great. There's so many things to live and talk about and grow. God bless you guys. And for you guys that are great people as well, and you're listening to this video, the great people, I just said all these things that you can apply to your life. You apply these things to your life. You apply these things for you to grow. You apply them in anything. And you're going to find these type of humans everywhere you go. Make sure that you never hate her. Make sure that you recognize when somebody does good. Even if you don't like the person, man, but you know he did good. He went all the rounds and did whatever. I don't like the guy, but he did a great show. You don't even have to say I don't like the guy, because when you say I don't like the guy, you become already a little bitch. But for me, many times I applaud for people that I don't like. And I don't say I don't like them, but I applaud for them because I like winners. A lot of people say, Chico, you are from the Cowboys. And yeah, I'm a Cowboy. I have a Cowboy hat I use all the time. And I love the Cowboys. I love Cowboy Stadium. I am from Houston. And I love the Cowboys. They won so many championships and everything. And, you know, right now everything is in a very heavy drought. And it hurts sometimes, you know. But who do I think is the greatest quarterback of all times? Tom Brady. Oh, he's not a Cowboy. I recognize greatness. You know, one thing is about me being fan of the Cowboys, but Tom Brady is the greatest. I'm a very big fan of my dogs, but I can tell you how great are my dogs because I know what they have done. Same thing in life. You're always gonna find people. I hope that this channel here, which is not a channel to sell dogs, is a channel that can make you happy, that can make you feel great, that can make you grow, have some growth, and you can apply it to your life and be a great person. We live in a very confusing world. I hope that you boys stay boys, and I hope that you girls stay girls. God bless you.